What do you think is the difference between these two glasses of milk? Today we are going to learn the answer with my experiment, Magic Hot Cocoa. Hi, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab some cocoa because this experiment is gonna be sweet. Emily's Science Lab, stay curious and keep exploring. Emily's Science Lab, stay curious and keep exploring. For this one, you need some cocoa, not hot chocolate mix, cocoa, a couple of spoons, and some cold or room temperature water. What you wanna do is get a small amount of cocoa in one of your spoons, just about that much. And we are going to completely submerge this in our water, just like so. And now watch what happens when I take my other spoon and just tap the surface. Did you see that? The water flew away, revealing dry cocoa underneath. So what's happening here? Well, there are two important ingredients in cocoa. Starch, which is hydrophilic, meaning hydro, water, and philic, to have a fondness of something, so literally water-loving, and fat, which is hydrophobic, or water-fearing, meaning it repels water. We saw that water on the surface of our cocoa. That was the starch on the surface of our cocoa quickly sucking up all of that water. And the surface tension in the water was holding it all together like a little starchy water jacket. But as soon as we hit the surface with our spoon, we broke that surface tension and that film of water fell right off, revealing the dry cocoa underneath. That's the fat in cocoa working for us here. The fat was repelling the water so that it just fell right off. And if we go ahead and just try to put our cocoa in cold water or in this room temperature water, it doesn't mix like it's supposed to. It doesn't dissolve. Why does cocoa work in hot water or in hot milk, but not in cold water or cold milk? Well, that has to do with the energy that's in hot water and hot milk. When it's hot, all of those molecules are moving around so much faster that they can break up the fat in cocoa, making it easier to dissolve. And that's why it's called hot cocoa, not cold cocoa. Parents and adults, be a little bit careful with the cocoa powder because this stuff can get messy. Thanks for making Magic Hot Cocoa with me. If you like this one, check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for more things, science, and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.